Ano po ang magiging kaibahan nito, sir, dito sa ng bagong Department of Migrant Affairs sa DFA at POEA? Bakit kailangan pa ng hiwalay na departamento?
Una sa lahat lang, Cheryl, supposedly today at 5 o'clock natirmahan, pero unfortunately, may ano tayo sa GGAA na 2022, yung budget natin. And may kalamidad, I'm also from Cebu, natamaan kami sa Odette. So I was informed by the PLLO na postpone. Hopefully, hindi Christmas gift, New Year's gift na lang ng Pangulo. Mm-hmm. So as to your question, ma'am, simply lang, the core agency will be the POEA. And then you have six other agencies. You have DOLE, ma-absorb dyan for the Department of Migrant Workers, or for example, the ILAB, the International Division of DOLE, and you also have the POLOS, and so on and so forth. And you also have, from the DFA, you have the Office of the Undersecretary of Migrant Affairs. Although, yung mga funds niya na ATN or the Legal Assistance Fund shall be retained sa DFA. And of course, we also have the Action Fund that will be established. Yung amount dati in our hearings in Congress, we were asking for $5 billion. And so on and so forth. Sa DSWD naman, yung OSHWA, yung Social Welfare Officers, will be integrated. And you have the Maritime Polytechnic, yung Commission of Filipino Overseas, hindi nasama, Cheryl.
Okay, so pagsasama-samahin po itong mga ilang mga ahensya at departamento under sa Office of Department of Migrant Affairs. Pero kung kunwari po ako isang OFW, baka po ang tanong nila, okay, ano ang kaibahan niyan? Ano ang ikagaganda ng mga benepisyo or serbisyo na makukuha ko?
Yeah, we always say that they're modern day heroes and they, you know, 10 million reasons, no? You have OFWs all over the world na, and then 2 million pre-COVID times umaalis each year. Right now, we're doing what? According to POEA, 500,000 to 600. The point is, you have so many of our stakeholders. You have so many OFWs. We are one of the few countries that are actually labor sending. I don't want to use that word, but unfortunately, that we are. Like Nepal. Nepal, actually, in our ILO conferences, will say that they copy actually our laws. Magaling daw tayo ang Pilipinas. Going back to that, you know, if I am the OFW, say up in Kuwait or in Saudi Arabia, then you have a problem. Ang daming agencies. I just mentioned to you that there are about 7 agencies. And then you have the tatlong departamento, my DSWD, my DFA, Foreign Affairs, and merong DOLE. So ikaw ang the OFW, and then you kasakatutak ng daming hotlines, di ba?
Yes.
So there must be an integrated, holistic approach, one country approach. And on this particular problem, so I already mentioned ang dami, we cannot, let us accept the fact that malaking debate ito, that we should, we are institutionalizing Filipinos by sending them, we're commodity ba? That we're sending them to countries. Why? Simply because they have no jobs here. If there are trabajo, survival wages. So Cheryl, that is the problem. So we are at least focused. If you are the OFW, then you know where to go. Then you know what hotline. Hindi yung at present right now, you have 4 hotlines. That's crazy. That should not, it's not sustainable. The status quo is not sustainable, Cheryl.
Mm-hmm. Sir, isa sa malaking problema po pagdating sa mga OFWs natin ay yung illegal recruitment, maging yung mga undocumented. Mm-hmm. So ito na po talaga ang ahensya at wala po tayong pipiliin dito. Legal at illegal, undocumented at documented ay makatutulungan po ng departamentong ito.
Ito sa Senate Bill, we're actually using the Senate Bill. Yung kami naman sa House Bill namin, we said yes already to the, of course, wala namang masyadong kaibahan. You say, the mandate alone tells you, na sinasabi, it protects and promotes. And then it doesn't, regardless kung illegal ka or legal, ang sabi to, the status of means of entry into the country of destination. Problema, ang dami talaga na talagang undocumented na umalis dito, hindi nagbayad ng $25 ng OWAP funds that you have to pay for as a member. And then, pang-tourist, and then na kita na trabaho doon. So that is the main problem. So again, we seek to address this particular concern para sa Department ng to, Department of Migrant Workers.
Mm-hmm. Sabi niyo nga po, you're hoping sana today mapirmahan, pero hindi po mangyayari yan. And of course, you're hoping na sana within the week, ano, bago po magbagong taon. Once na mapirmahan po ito ni Pangulong Duterte, ano pong susunod?
Well, there, kung hindi niya pirmahan, presidential inaction, being also a lawyer, 30 days, it lapses into law, Cheryl. Mm-hmm. But definitely, I'd like to see it because I'm actually here now in Manila, expecting that to attend the signing ceremonies. Now they're saying probably Zoom, or kung hindi Zoom, and they're saying also baka sa December 30. So I will wait. Hopefully, it's already here, finally. Mm-hmm, after so many years and congresses, ma'am, nandito na. Terma na lang kulang. Hindi naman ba dapat mabito yan kasi presidential promise yan, di ba, ma'am?
Opo. So kung pag po ito ay napirmahan na ni Pangulong, o basta naging batas na po siya, ay gaano kabilis mabubuo po or target na mabuo at makumpleto at na magkaroon ng secretary po ang departamentong ito? Within the year, 2022?
Well, for the GAA of this year, hindi nasama yung appropriations niya. So nasabi natin, that's why we don't put any appropriations para mabilis. So there's a two-year transition period composed of the president right now can actually appoint a secretary of the DMW once signed, no? And of course, lapse, publish, etc. So there's a two-year transition period, and all those agencies that I mentioned will come together and ibuo nila. So I foresee probably 2023, but. It's getting there, ma'am. And of course, you have congressional oversight sa Kongreso, sa Senado, and then may mandatory review. Quickly lang, ha, this is the only department that I know may parang self-executing, may expiry date. It has 5 years or, at the pleasure of the president, na pwede tanggalin. Meaning, kung after 5 years of review, 5 years and 5 years, if they see that they don't need, there is no need of having this department, then we can say we will abolish this department.
Pero magandang balita po ito sa ating mga overseas Filipino workers.
Yes,
documented ka or undocumented man. But of course, ang kanilang inaasahan ay sana talaga ito na po ang sasagot sa mga concerns, mga problema ng ating mga modern-day heroes.